In this example, we have a subsidiary that will change into an IFRS 9 investment. Entity A acquired 80% in Entity B on 1 January 2020 at cost of 80,000, which is deemed to be the fair value on that date. Entity A disposed of 50% of the shares in Entity B for 75,000 on 1 July 2021, assumed to be a financial asset in terms of IFRS 9 from this date. Entity B recognized a profit of 15,000 for the year ended 31 December 2020. Entity B recognized a profit for the 6-month period till 30 June 2021 of 5,000. The net asset value of Entity B was 120,000 on date of disposal. The fair value of the retained interest was 45,000 on date of disposal. Now we're able to identify that this is the 30%. Entity A accounts for the investments in associates and subsidiaries at cost in its separate financial statements in terms of IAS 27 paragraph 10A. Entity A classifies this investment as a financial asset in terms of IFRS 9 in its separate financial statements and irrecoverably elected to present subsequent changes in the fair value of the investment in other comprehensive income in a mark-to-market reserve. Entity A elected to transfer any cumulative gains or losses within equity in terms of IFRS 9.B5.7.1. When will this be applicable? When they sell. Now guys, in this scenario, it's a sub that changed into an IFRS 9 investment. Entity A elected to measure non-controlling interest at proportionate share. Year in 31 December, ignore all taxes and assume no consolidation occurred on date of change. Perform journal entries in both records only relating to the information provided. Right, now step number one. We've identified that originally this is a subsidiary 80%. Shares and then they sell 50%, therefore minus 50%, and this is now a normal IFRS 9 investment. We need to apply IFRS 10B98. Step number two, let's have a look at our timeline. In the separate records of Entity A, Entity A will have to recognize the subsidiary at cost in terms of IAS 27. Therefore, if we look at our timeline, the pink portion, again, subsidiary. And the separate records, then this change into an IFRS 9 investment. Now, in the separate records, at initial recognition, Entity A will debit the investment credit bank with a cost. Now, again, if you are standing on 1 July 2021 and Entity A sell 50% of the shares, we will have to recognize the sales transaction. Therefore, debit bank with the 75,000, credit the investment because we need to take out 50%. Therefore, this will be the 80,000 times 50 over 80, and this will be 50,000. And we will credit profit relating to this transaction to the value of 25,000. In the separate records, what is our next step? We now need to measure the retained interest, the 30%. We need to measure at fair value. Now, the 30%, the cost is the 30,000. Remember, it is your 80,000 times 30 over 80. Therefore, our fair value is 45,000 and we will have a 15,000 fair value adjustment. In the separate records, we will have to debit the investment and credit. Now guys, what do we credit? The mark-to-market reserve or our fair value adjustment? We will credit our fair value adjustment in our profit and loss with the 15,000. Why? because this is a rule in terms of IFRS 10. Remember, this is still a subsidiary at this date. Okay, therefore this is a rule in terms of IFRS 10. We need to measure the fair value adjustment. We need to remeasure our retained interest, the 30% at fair value. Right, now I want you to focus and I want you to please look at our group at the bottom. Again, guys, we have not yet consolidated. We have not yet consolidated. Now, for our 15,000 relating to our retained interest, 80% will have to be allocated to our parent, 20% to our NCI, the same with the 5,000, 80% parent and 20% NCI. Right, therefore, when we look at this, guys, remember, we will now have to include the 12,000 and the 4,000 into our investment. Therefore, debit the investment in our subsidiary with the 16,000. And we need to include our NCI, 3,000, 1,000, therefore add the 4,000. Right. Now, if we want to determine what is our net asset value at the beginning of the section 1 January, we are able to use our closing balance minus the 15,000, minus the 5,000. And this will be 100,000. Therefore, we are able to determine of this 100,000, 80,000 is allocated to our parent and 20,000 is allocated to our NCI. Okay. Now, on 1 July 2021, Entity A disposed of 50%. What do we need to do? We now need to recognize the group profit or loss. Therefore, on the right side of your screen, remember your group profit or loss. How do we calculate this? We will have to take out the assets and liabilities, which is the 120,000 net asset value. And this should include our NCI portion. Now, if I indicate include, we need to take out the NCI portion. Remember, look at this from what the entity will receive versus what the entity will have to give. Now, the entity will have to give and take out the assets and liabilities and NCI. Now, what is the value of our NCI? The original 20,000, yes, plus the 3,000, plus the 1,000. Therefore, if we include this, it's the 20,000 plus the 3,000 plus the 1,000. And this will be 24,000. Therefore, they will have to take out the 96,000. Okay, what do we need to include? What should be included? The fair value of the retained investment, which is the 45,000, plus the selling price, the consideration received, which is the 75,000. When you look at our principles, guys, and the middle column relating to loss of control, derecognize assets and liabilities, which we need to take out. This is the 120,000 minus our 24,000 relating to our NCI, and this is 96,000. We need to take this out. Then recognize, include the fair value of the consideration received, 75,000, and the retained interest at fair value. I completely forgot. It's 45,000. The retained interest at fair value, 45,000. Therefore, include the 120,000. Therefore, we are able to identify a group profit to be recognized of 24,000. Right. Therefore, we now need to recognize our group profit. If we recognize the group profit, oh, let me just complete my calculation here as well. Hey, okay, so we are able to identify that this now will now be 24,000 group profit because we need to take out and this we need to include 24,000 24,000 group profit, right? Now, journal entry, credit our group profit of 24,000, and we need to take out our separate entities profit. Why? Because at this point of time, when we consolidate assets plus assets of parent plus subsidiary liabilities, we add everything, we are going to include the separate records profits as well. We can't, because then we double count, therefore debit the profit relating to our separate records, and this is the 25,000. And then we credit our investment with the balancing figure. Right. Now, guys, look at this. Do you agree with me? For this period in our group, this is a normal IFRS 9 investment in the records of entity A. Therefore, do we have anything included in our group now? Should we have anything included in the group? No, we shouldn't have anything included in the group. Therefore, if you now look at this, we will have to reverse this journal entry, because at this point of time, they still consolidate. Therefore, it will still be included in our group. And we therefore now need to take this out. But look at this. We will have to debit our day one gain or loss with the 15,000. And we will credit our investment with the 15,000. We need to take this out. Right. Now let's just take this one step back and summarize our steps. Right. Remember, no consolidation occurred on days of change. If we look at only the separate records of entity A, we will have to determine one, the profit or loss on the sale transaction. Number two, we need to remeasure the interest retained. The interest retained at fair value. Right. Now, in our group, we will have to take out the profits relating to our separate records. We need to calculate our group profit or loss on the sales transaction. Remember, your balancing figure will be recognized to your investment. And we will have to then take out this journal entry. We will reverse this in our group. Right. Now, let's just quickly have a look at what the balances will be in the separate entities records on date of disposal. Now, when we look at this separate entities records, guys, please. In the separate entities records, we will have a remaining balance of 45,000. And this is financial asset, and this will be the fair value. You see, guys, this will be the fair value. In the group records, there should be no evidence of this entity anymore because they sold it. Therefore, if you look at our journal entry on the left side, we've debited the investment with the 16,000. Then we credit with 1,000 and we credit with 15,000. Do you see? Debited, we added the 16,000, then we minus 1,000, then we minus 15,000, and the balance is zero. Okay, so let's just get back to our principles. Okay, guys, look at the column loss of control for me, right? Or the three of them at this point of time. And then I want you to look at the left one. Remember, we've indicated here, middle of your screen, at fair value, the IFRS 9 investment, or cost, if it's an associate or JV. Now, look at the differences. This is our example where we have our subsidiary that change into an associate. If you look at the separate records for me, please, the separate records, we are able to identify that our investment in the associate is at cost. Look at your revision page. The investment in associate at cost. If you look at the separate records in our example where we have a subsidiary that changed into an IFRS 9 investment, our investment in the separate records is at fair value. Look at this. We've indicated that it should be at fair value. Okay, guys? What I want you to be able to do is look at the different examples. Put them next to each other. Identify your different steps. Understand them. Why? And guys, I hate it when my lecturers always told me, but because IFRS tells you to do this. But unfortunately, it is the truth. IFRS tells us what to do, and we just need to follow the principles. Right. Now, in the last section of changing control, we are going to cover IFRS 10, paragraph 23.